Across the long history of glacial interglacial cycles, there is no question but what the atmosphere's CO2 concentration is strongly correlated with its temperature, as is demonstrated by numerous scientific studies. Nor is there any question about the fact that changes in air temperature generally occur anywhere from 800 to 2800 years before changes in the air's CO2 content, as is demonstrated by even more studies. Consequently, we know that carbon dioxide cannot be the primary cause of glacial interglacial temperature changes. But could it still be a significant amplifier of them, as many climate alarmists claim it to be? In considering this question, we note that Antarctic ice core data suggest that the air's current CO2 concentration is some 30% higher than it was at any other time in the last 650,000 years, and that its current methane concentration is 130% higher, values that some scientists have referred to as geologically incredible. Thus, if the world's climate alarmists are correct about the tremendous warming power they attribute to these two greenhouse gases, one would expect the Earth to currently be experiencing incredibly high temperatures compared to those of prior interglacial periods. So what do the ice core data imply in this regard? Both the Dome Concordia and Vostok data suggest that the mean recent temperature of the current interglacial or Holocene was not incredibly higher than temperatures reached during all of the past four interglacials, the earliest of which is believed to have been nearly identical to the Holocene in terms of Earth's orbit around the Sun. In fact, the mean recent temperature of the Holocene did not exceed temperatures reached during any of the four prior interglacials, by even a tiny fraction of a degree. In fact, the mean recent temperature of the Holocene was lower. In fact, the work of Pettit et al. Suggests that the mean recent temperature of the Holocene was more than 2 degrees centigrade lower than the highest temperatures of the prior four interglacials. And in fact, the most recent analysis of the subject suggests that the maximum interglacial temperatures over the past 340,000 years were between 6 and 10 degrees centigrade above present-day values. Isn't this just the opposite of what one would expect if carbon dioxide and methane were the fantastically powerful greenhouse gases climate alarmists claim them to be? Clearly, if there's anything unusual, unnatural, or unprecedented about Earth's current surface air temperature, it is that it is so darn cold. Yes, something is certainly rotten in Denmark, and it is currently holding court in Copenhagen.